ready for a new level, guys?
Yay, and hopefully not a glitch-tastic one like last time.
That was only a boss fight. That never happened to me before, so...
Anyway...
We're at the Stratoport Stratospheric Airport.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play. Hey, the wonderful 101, and we are the insane new one in the last episode. We experienced a glitch-tastic fucking... I don't know what.
Oh, if you look at the map, Blossom City is in the very middle of the crater of California. See?
So maybe that's the reason why they're still in Los Angeles. On the map, the crater is a lot bigger than the next.
I'd like to point out that Panama just completely got destroyed. Greenland is the upper regions of Canada is an absolute mess. Russia has a hole in it. There's a giant fault line through Russia and India.
And Africa.
Yeah.
Western Africa.
Pretty sure Spain is gone.
Britain, France, Spain, and Portugal, and Italy just kind of moved off somewhere. Sweden.
Greece is destroyed.
Sweden, Norway, and all of them are one landmass again, when normally they're islands.
The fuck happened to Greenland?
Iceland's, I don't know where the flying fuck it may actually be covered up by the picture over there, I don't know.
Maybe. But anyway, yeah, this is what happened to the entire planet after the last Getstrick invasion.
South America looks really fucked up, granted, most of the
I think South America and Australia look to be the most complete ones out of everything.
Indonesia's missing quite a few islands.
Alaska just grew a neck. I'd like to point out that out.
New Zealand seems to be just floating the fuck away.
What happened to Hawaii?
It seems like the airport is actually over Hawaii.
It's closer,
or at least over where it should be.
I don't believe Hawaii is south of the equator.
I'm just saying where it should be. I'm not sure. I'm not entirely sure.
Okay, that's
it
enough.
Looks very well.
Okay.
Anyway,
that's enough of the geography. That's enough of a geography lesson.
Enough of the weird geography lesson of this game. Wasn't that hard? It's called Invade Everything. Displaying strategic information now. I'm showing a massive enemy fleet in sector S. Coming up with anything?
I got nothing. I'm just waiting for the actual level to pop up. And Red is the only one out of the main group so far that knows what the fuck is going on.
Weird, considering the fact that they're...
Red's been on the team for the least amount of time.
Yep. Aliens invading, go get them. There.
And he's like, really, guys?
Hink and Red are probably like, you really don't understand this shit.
Thanks,
shit.
Blue! Way to go, Green.
Thank you, Pink.
Thanks, Pink.
There they go again.
Sucking their own dick, Platinum. Mother Platinum.
Love right smartphone?
She's talking about pee.
No.
I don't even have a head, pee. Just went, I don't even have access to the top secret information.
I only doubt he's about to hack into that because... By the way, I'm getting nuts, in case you can't tell what that means.
Peanuts!
Peanuts are awesome.
Yes, they are.
Actually, that brings up a point. As we were having a conversation about Kozioka earlier, and that makes me wonder. There were times where Odd complained about being hungry in Lyoko. When that doesn't make any sense. They're technically programs. Programs aren't meant to get hungry.
I would like to point this out, but you probably wouldn't mind. Probably one like it, in Digimon, when the characters are stuck in the digital world, there's only been one instance where the humans don't get hungry. Everybody in every other continuity, they still feel hunger because their body is telling them, "Hey, you haven't fed me in a while. Feed me!"
Granted, there
bodies may be data, but their instincts are still the same.
Granted, the Mega Man fan film also had Mega Man and Roll be able to eat, even though they never really needed to.
It was a good fan film, in my opinion. Did you like it?
Yeah, it was certainly better than the Sonic fan film they made, even though
they made a Sonic fan film.
It's the really, really short one where Knuckles has fingers at the end. Sonic looks incredibly fucking weird, and it's just How could the people that made this? How could the people that make such a good fan film make such a shitty one at the same time?
Well, with Mega Man, the realistic proportions and everything work. I never watched the Sonic one, so I can't really tell what the fuck is going on there.
They even changed Eggman's name for some reason.
What, instead of Ivo and Robotnik, it's...
I can't even remember, it's just something stupid. I think it was Russian of some kind. By the way, which level of this... this operation, where do we get our next Unicorn?
It's always the first one of every level.
Okay. So we'll be getting our next Unicorn in this level, which is awesome. Mm-hmm. When's the next Gorgon fight?
Not until Chapter 4.
Okay.
And I think I'll be fighting that one.
I would think so.
It's either in Chapter 4 1 or Chapter 4 2.
I'm doing the final one, right?
Yeah.
The way you figure this out.
Hey, look! Luca, you're supposed to be in sick bay. Why do you know my name? Because that's what the other kids at school call you? You all hatched up, Sneaky. I was nothing, just a scrap. Hey, you guys are gonna go fight those aliens, right? I know you can't do it alone. I'll go with you. Sorry, little dude.
Kid.
Ankle biters and firefights don't mix.
Kid, without one of these mask thingies, you are nothing. He's got a point. Oh, snap. You know, Beastar, you could probably just pick him up and fly him back to the Virgin Victory. Look, there's no time to argue. Luke is
coming with us. Since Red is Luca's teacher,
just fly him back to the Virgin Victory.
P is not that strong.
Then
okay, guys, watch this.
Then teleport him or something. I don't know.
We recruited Luca, and he's considered a permanent party member.
Sort of.
Allow me. Oh. Sorry, guys. Can't forget you. I am a courteous leader. I am a courteous savior. Oh, by the way.
Except for when I accidentally slashed you in the face.
It's okay. I made amends. I made up for that. And I go. I personally really like Stratosphere. Strataport.
Shouldn't we be dying?
No, the masks protect a lot.
Well, I mean, ooh. Well, I mean, like, the wind would be so damn hard that it would just blow us off.
Apparently, we're equipped with Magna Shoes.
That's...
Hey, look! A UFO!
That's a better explanation than nothing. Hello.
Envin?
I'm reminded of the Skipsozola.
Skip. Ago. Yeah, I can see why. But it's not jellyfishy enough. It's close. Very close. A lot of batteries!
Okay, I'm just gonna move the fucking couch. We don't need a guide. Couch. Bed. We don't need a guide for this, so I'm gonna move.
Okay. Just be in a spot where the microphone can actually pick you up.
I'm just doing it to avoid the goddamn squeaking. And I want my nuts.
I'll just move this farther that way, so that way things will be easier on all of us.
Yeah. the bed down. Much better.
I hate these big guys.
Excuse me.
That's weird. Their health bar's not popping up for some reason. I'm punching them.
I never really noticed they had one. It was usually defined by their cockpit color.
It's been a while since I've done this. I'm a little bit rusty.
Do you like any other nuts? Do you like nuts other than peanuts?
I tried cashews. They're pretty good.
Well, technically peanuts aren't nuts. I forget exactly what they are, but whatever.
Okay.
I always find it
fire!
Weird.
And I missed!
I always find it weird how something can have a certain word in a name, but it's not actually that thing, like donuts or peanuts. Well, donuts are obviously not made of nuts, but whatever.
I just remember what Starfire called them. The nuts of dough.
Evil beware, we have waffles.
I love that show.
Raven had some of the best humor in that show, in my opinion, just because of how blunt it is.
Yes.
I'm a big fan of blunt humor.
Yeah, same here. Remember when Dr. Bright was robbing an oil platform and...
I didn't watch the show too, but terribly much.
Okay. And Raven just said to Dr. Bright, next time you decide to rob somebody, rob somewhere, don't pick somewhere where we can see from our living room window.
She's got a point. She's got a very big point there.
Nah. I haven't been given
like it would be like...
Oh! Didn't know I could do that.
It would be like robbing a store right outside of Wayne Manor. Granted, they would have no idea about that, but still.
Evil beware. We have waffles. For some reason, I picked them up, but I can't pick them up again?
I think he has to be in a helpless state. Like, on his back or something. Just punch him to death.
I am! See? Dead! And... oh, it's done. Oh, great.
You almost made it, but the game wouldn't let you.
Shouldn't I be able to... oh, I did. Oh, shit! The chain broke apart.
Bye.
This is a pretty good theme playing right now. Shut up. Hey, I'm doing better on damage than you did. Not against the boss fight, but against your actual levels. Oh, I love this character! About to die.
Oh, shit.
Want me to pause it?
No, I got it.
Okay.
By the way, in French, whenever you're talking about a teacher, you can actually just shorten it to just prof.
Prof?
Prof.
Okay.
Come on. This thing has not been holding the charge very much lately.
Okay.
Work.
Yeah, it's good.
I was gonna say it should be working. You wanna continue the Kozuyoko conversation?
After recording.
Well, considering the fact that we have nothing to talk about at the moment.
See, even Professor Shiragane gets in on the insulting green with some Frenchy sounding words. One of my favorite at the very end is that he just says, "Oh, shut up, Frere Jacques."
Frere Jacques?
Yeah.
That doesn't sound French to me.
French nursery rhyme.
Oh. I think I've heard it before, actually.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
I've heard it before. I have most definitely heard it before. You can just break chains by making your damn thing.
It's sharp. Very sharp. Ah! It fires so hard it knocks people into their underwear.
Yeah, I find that weird how whenever someone who is not a wonderful one gets knocked out, they're put into their underwear rather than their ordinary clothes.
But when you die, you end up getting knocked into your underwear. I think it breaks even.
Well, we're better than knocked out. We have to be killed in order for that to happen.
True. Meet my Giga Hand!
I always found drawing on other drawing shapes when transferring between different surfaces, like the floor and the wall, to be very weird. It's like, how does the game know what you're trying to do? It's hard enough to tell what you're trying to do yourself, let alone the game. Let alone figure out what the game is thinking.
Oh, I recruited it! Awesome! I already just recruited one of those big jerk enemies. They shrunk down.
I was gonna say. He just got punched in the face by one of his own dudes. Oh, great, the little guys have swords now.
They've always had swords. And I recruited another one!
I thought they were just punching each other. Not punching each other, punching you. You get my point. Oh, great.
Oh, hoedown.
Yeah, it's impossible to tell which one they are until they shoot at you.
I noticed Raydowns are a bit more blue. I'm almost about to die because this Dogu is getting pot shots.
Ooh, items. I was gonna say, you may want to take care of the hoedowns. I'm surprised that thing still has its shield.
You were saying?
There we go.
It's so weird seeing a enemy Geth jerk inside my Unite guts. That sounds so weird. Okay, just watch.
Yeah, it looks weird and it sounds weird.
See, look.
The mask is poking out of the thing.
Yeah, I'm taking a medium suit. Okay, guys, and bathroom break.
Are there ways to permanently, like, extend how many batteries you have?
Because
I know finding wonderful ones is how you increase your health.
And also, permanently, your batteries stay upgraded throughout the entire operation. But they go back, to normal between operations.
Well, I'm not talking about unlocking them, I'm talking about I'm talking about getting more of them to unlock with batteries.
You do realize that we're in a room full of poison gas and Ping is worried about her complexion. Save the civilians!
Not even Sissy would be that worried. She would more so.
You are in a very good looking mood today.
That I am.
Got a new wonderful one.
She would more so be worried about
the Wonder movie! Hey, he's black and white.
She would more so be worried about getting the flying fuck out of there. Wait, question. How old were they in Kalioka?
I'd say 14.
And Odd's supposed to be the youngest of them?
Apparently.
Well, they certainly took that... They certainly made that apparent in evolution.
And... new party member!
Hello.
I love this guy.
Hello, Mr. Roshan.
Oh, his eyes. How'd you get up there?
Damn. Thank you, Pink.
Hammering Ruski?
Hammering Ruski? Do we really need to replace the C with a K?
It's Capitan.
I know it's Russian, but that doesn't mean it needs to be replaced with a C. Or replace the C with a K. You get my point.
Do you agree with Blue right there?
Yes. Come on.
Okay, here we go.
I want to get
look at this. Hey, look, he's hunched down like he's trying to take a shit.
You are the only one that would make that reference, because even I didn't make that reference.
No, I'm just saying, it looks like he's taking a shit.
Not even I would say that.
Now, just so you know, after Pink, they really don't have much character interactions. So Yellow kind of gets a bit of a backseat, as well as the next wonders that we'll be getting.
Why did he do the weird one?
Just because. He had to be quirky. Okay. This one took me a while to do. But I can do it perfectly now. And Hammer.
Well, the thing is, I never took Yellow to be a fabulous person.
He's really not. That was just for a little joke that he did. And Hammer time!
Yeah, Hammer is Jeff's second favorite Unite Morph in the game behind
It's slow, but it's powerful as all hell.
Behind Naginata, which is fast and powerful at the same time.
And it defends, too!
Sort of.
It blocks projectiles.
Well.
It's like I was saying.
It also lets you fly, basically. Seriously, that thing may as well be a fucking helicopter.
But how fast he's spinning?
Unite helicopter! And it's just Naginata just twirling horizontally instead of vertically so it can fly.
Look at that! Did you see how powerful Ultra Hammer does?
God damn.
And the fire lasts up.
And you already ranked them up once. And you do that through using them, so.
But so, I'd like to point out that
please go gambling? I would rather be doing that than fighting these fuckers. Hey, stop destroying the roulette wheel! Oh yeah, by the way, just a quick mention.
Never gamble, people. Outside of a video game.
Well, gambling can be fun in real life, it's just depending on whether or not you win. Although, if you do notice yourself winning quite a bit, leave. Leave before you... Don't push your luck, because if you keep winning whenever you're getting the streak, the casino owner will get mad.
They'll realize something's up.
And they'll either think you're too good and kick you out themselves...
Or you're cheating.
And if you are cheating, that can land you in some serious legal shit. Because, well, yes, it's gambling, that doesn't mean you can cheat at it.
Come on, buddy, calm down.
It's not like we've been gambling, we just know what can happen.
I've seen a couple movies that revolved around gambling, and I read a book. You ever heard of a book called Plum Lucky?
Nope.
Pretty good book.
I've seen lots of cop shows based on it.
Plum Lucky?
No, just cop shows with gambling shit.
I hate these fuckers.
I thought it was a disco ball.
You'd be wrong.
Oh wait, these are the fuckers you need Hammer for.
These turtle pricks are a pain in the ass to deal with.
And they give you two of them at once for their first encounter.
Exactly!
Shit.
Magang. Do you think they're referencing Matang? Hold on.
If that were the case, they'd be floating.
But, eh.
By the way, this game has even weirder enemy names than Pikmin does, so don't expect us to remember them. Wait, you were just punching them.
With a jerk weapon. Oh! Already got a wonderful snigger.
Yeah, given how slow Hammer is, it kind of makes sense that he would get it that quickly.
Although it's better than, can you just imagine having a metal bulb orb? Is that a thing in Pikmin 2?
Not 2. I don't know why, but I get the weird feeling that something like that is a thing in 3.
Oh yeah, that's what kind of makes these things a bit annoying. They have the ability to make fire pillars pop up all over the place. And they can follow.
I'm having horrible flashbacks of Entei from Ranger 1.
Entei was not...
So many goddamn fire pillars.
Entei was not that bad.
Then he decided to be nice to you. Because that thing was pure fucking torture for me. And I still haven't beaten them.
You had needed me to beat the game for you.
Well, I haven't even played the game since I had you do that, I'll be honest.
It's a pretty fun game. It's pretty fun.
My favorite in the Ranger series is Shadows of Almia.
I don't blame you. I like Guardian Science soundtrack.
Ranger 1 is easily my least favorite, and it's not because it's a bad game, I just think it's my least, I just find it to be my least favorite.
Underwhelming. Well, it's the first attempt. You can't really expect it for it to be absolute magnum opus.
It also came out before Gen 4 did, so they didn't have quite as many Pokemon to work with.
But Ranger was my first game on my DS, Nintendo Dogs not including.
Which is kind of funny considering the fact that Pokemon Pinball was the first game he had for his GBA. Pokemon Pinball Ruby and Sapphire.
Do you want to know what the game came with the GBA box?
What?
Zero Mission.
Actually, I think most GBAs did that, even though Zero Mission came out later.
Well, it was my.
I'm not sure.
Well, mine was a GBA SP. Don't get too comfy there, buddy. You're gonna be playing your mission before too long.
I know. My SP didn't come with Zero Mission, but my first GBA game is actually Pokemon Ruby.
Huh.
I remember that very clearly. And then I believe I got Emerald and some other weird licensed game stuff. I don't know.
Okay, it's dead. I really hate those things.
I may have had Sapphire at some point.
Got a bronze. I don't care. Okay, time to go gambling.
Wait, do you actually have to do this, or is it just something I can do?
Something I can do. Oop, got nothing.
Is it playing the Wonder Mart music?
Yeah. Oh, goddammit. I thought I was close.
There's this thing called timing. How about you try it? Okay, then. Okay, I'm gambling now. Oh, yeah.
We got money! I wanted to get the platinum mark.
I assume it gives you a platinum coin or something?
I don't know. Never really bothered.
You have two of your enemies and a whole bunch of fat dudes running around. I find that funny for some reason.
The soldier's gone apeshit. And he's leaving.
Wait, I thought you were getting sword. You know, I'm fairly certain sword would be better for this situation. Wait, grab the box.
I know, I see the box.
You hit the chandelier, not the box.
I hit the box.
Well, the game counted it as you hitting the box, even though you clearly hit the chandelier instead. By the way, it's getting kind of late, so maybe we should stop after this.
Okay.
Well, obviously...
Records on tomorrow.
Reports on tomorrow and wait for the operation to actually, finish.
And start a bit of 4?
No.
Ooh, that was close.
Well, I meant to say just. You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know.
Well, wait to finish this until tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And start a bit of 4 tomorrow.
Okay, that should be. Oh, nope, I'm not letting a single one survive.
How many operations are there again?
9.
So, completing this operation will mean we're a third of the way through the game.
Yeah. This game is not really all that long, but man, is it fun. Okay, down I go.
Can I assume we get white in Chapter 4?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a platinum coin on the way down.
Apparently. I do kind of wish that your group, that your mom could get things for you.
Yeah, that's one thing that the game has a really weird time trying to figure out whether you're trying to make whip or hammer. I don't personally feel like it would be that big of a deal, but...
They're asking for help in front of the trash can.
But the game does have a weird time figuring it out sometimes. There we go, Jesus.
Wait, what?
I think this is one of those rare instances where you need a full squad of 100 in order to get...
Look at my icon. No, it's like I'm putting them all in there.
Come on.
Get in there!
Get in there.
No running away from destiny.
It is your destiny to be in the porta potty.
Over crying out loud, Luca! Get in there!
Wait, is that Luca?
I don't know.
Get in there, Pipsqueak. Come on! Have you ever had this much trouble with a porta potty before?
Never. Come on,
Mr. Businessman.
Screw it.
Okay, need to go in here.
Sword time.
Open. Realize there's no power. How do we get said power?
Well, there's batteries right there from what it looks like.
Doesn't count. We gotta go up.
I'm just saying it looked like there was batteries. Wait, why did it make a chain? looking at the robot be a part of Unite Ladder is really funny.
Yeah, it is. Okay. What we have to do is...
How long have we been going for?
32 minutes.
Okay.
Okay, you just get your sword zapped by lightning, and then come down here with your sword charged to just turn the lock.
Will you lose your charge if your Unite form breaks?
I don't know. But there were enemies up there, and I must go kill them. Look at him at the very base of the chain!
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
You're laughing at ladder.
Well, both. I just kind of generally call it ladder, since that's the one that'll appear more often.
Look at green at the very bottom of the ladder.
Maybe that was just a ring of red. Does a lightning charge laser do more damage to these fuckers?
I don't know.
I wonder if blue has green in there.
Doubt it.
Well, considering the fact that green shot him out of his gun, maybe.
Oh! What?
Game, you could have told us this could happen.
I didn't even know that could happen.
Technically, this would have to be a new kind of enemy, so I don't understand why they didn't do it.
What? I hit A.
You're supposed to hit B instead. No, wait, B is on the bottom.
B's jump. Look at that fat guy on that sword.
Dude, you're messing up my thing. Grab the monies.
Of course I will grab the monies. The combo is piss poor because I never attacked them once.
Yep. I'm surprised you got a silver for that at all.
Well, I got a platinum on time.
Well, I mean, I'm surprised you got a silver.
Okay, let me try this one more time.
Get in there, people.
What the? Just getting them in there. The game just shits itself. Toilet!
Get in there, Wonder Toilet. Come on, it's porta potty. You would love it.
Wait, what? What? Get in the...
Get in the toilet.
Huh?
Is this another part of the glitch-tasticness that we had last episode?
I don't know.
Just go.
Yeah, I'm going. Oh, this part. Oh, joy.
I'm not liking the sound of that.
It's gonna be a gamepad section.
Hopefully not an overly long one. Deal with the giant blob of doom.
Does it remind you of the water wraith?
Sort of.
Without the cylinders.
a lot braver than it is without the cylinders.
Because you, because it doesn't see any purple Pikmin on you. Oh. Forgot this can happen.
Wait, what happens when you get a Shiragani drive level up?
I don't know.
Never been able to figure it
probably
out.
Probably means your battery lasts longer.
Well, that's what I was talking about earlier with shit like that, but... Well, it's dead. Money!
And soups.
What's with the rocket thingy down there?
You're about to find out when we get to it. Now, remember when I said hammer makes these things pretty easy?
Well, this thing has a hand thing on it, so we gotta wonder
what's
going on there.
No, it'll drop that hand thing, and the hand thing's a knob for something in this room. The enemy's basically guarding our progression.
Then why not just have it be part of the body for no apparent reason? Why have it on his back? And make it look like you could use
it
to beat it up.
Remember how much trouble we had with this thing in the beginning?
Yeah.
Dead! Okay, guys, follow me! It's just a handle. How hard is it? You guys coming? Okay.
By the way, we just have to mention one thing about hammer that's actually kind of funny, if you ask me. It can be used as an umbrella.
For missiles! Okay, now we're gonna see why I don't like this room. Wait, what? Apparently, it counted.
Okay.
And now
then
the room.
Why bother killing you?
To ruin my score at the very end of this mission. And now my view goes back to normal. On the actual TV. I hate that section. You can understand why.
Yeah.
I believe this is the Wonder Mart. Yeah, and I'm right.
That puts a real downer on what could possibly have been a really good level.
Mixer.
Especially concerning the fact that it...
Wait.
Especially... You put in however many...
Yeah, I know. I'm just wondering, what the heck is the ID card?
Make it. Wait, I just thought of something. It could be a discount card.
Let's take it!
Buy it.
A wonderful card.
Alright.
It does look like a credit card. Hey, it's not. It's actually Nelson's credit card!
Buy it. Well,
hey, look!
Make it. Oh, hello.
That was weird.
We had a very, very small gamepad sequence.
We get to use Nelson's credit card for one purchase.
Oh, so you get a free item.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I'll take it.
And you can actually use it immediately to buy one of the temporary upgrade things. Obviously, you'll have to go into the Wonder Mart first, but, you know.
Wonder Mart's right there. And Turtleoids are back. The McGangs.
Two more of these fuckers.
It's okay. Just a couple of hammer swings and they're dead.
We're digging.
You know, assuming they don't do that.
Yeah. Go away, you stupid sons of bitches. You know the Wonder Mart's right there. Why can't it just open up and fling them off?
What the? I had a circle at the end of that line.
And it looked like it was yellow when you actually did it, so I don't understand.
What?
Dude, don't make such a sharp curve. That's really freaking the game out.
Ow!
Use a wonderful kick. This entire session so far has just been kind of a train wreck.
Yeah, it has.
First off, we had my glitch-tastic adventures with the second boss of the game.
The gyroscope incident of Stratosport was what happened to me.
And and just a whole bunch of ugh. Hopefully this doesn't continue tomorrow.
Yeah, this interrupts my one of my favorite boss fights in my one, like my second favorite, like my favorite non-rival, non-final boss of the game. I'm gonna be pissed.
Your favorite normal boss?
Yeah.
Although there is one thing outside the game that can ruin your fun.
What? You should have known that was coming.
Well, I can say the same thing to you.
Got a silver.
I'm surprised that damage wasn't from the last section rather than this one. I'm not surprised. Considering the two continues you had to get on the stupid poison section.
That's not really a common thing, so thank God for that.
Alright, use that credit card. Get a custom block.
You know, I just remember something. We forgot to equip that other... Which one did we buy? We never bought one.
I was gonna say, we didn't buy any.
Speed charge?
Yep. Speed charge. Use the credit card. Wonderful card. Can you find those?
No.
Then why is it... whatever. Hooray for credit cards. You don't need to say it every single time you pull one out.
Red.
Yeah, red. You can only hold one of the supers at a time.
Mm-hmm.
How many stinks can you hold at a time?
One.
Okay, that makes sense. We don't really need attack liner.
We really don't.
And... Oh, okay. I forgot that was a thing. What does full automatic do?
Full automatic. Normal attacks will be performed automatically. Designed for beginners.
Easy mode.
Exactly.
It's easy, very easy mode. Well, technically it's just an auto attack function.
Yeah. Xenoblade style.
Yeah. Anyway, we have been the Insane Duo in the next part of Let's Play Wonderful 101. Hopefully we won't be encountering as many glitches as we were this episode. When I take the helm for Operation 3B, and I have no idea what we're gonna be doing, so. Anyway, we shall see you then. Bye-bye.